standing, Adam Lambert.
Ja, dat is een redelijke droom om zo'n grootheid te mogen ontmoeten.
Hele aardige, relaxte gast eigenlijk voor een wereldster.
I just watched the auditions and you guys all have such great voices. I'm here. I'm excited to hear you sing my song better than me.
No pressure.
No, no.
Does anybody have any questions about the song or? I was on a talent competition as well, so.
Well, I got a question about that.
Yeah.
For me, it was a very hard decision to make. To enter a contest like this.
Yeah.
I was just wondering how it was for you.
I auditioned with American Idol, the show that I was on. The cutoff age on that show is 28. And I was 27 when I auditioned. I never thought that was for me. I was like, no, no, no.
Yeah.
It's not for me. And then I got to that age and it was like a point in my career where I was kind of like, nothing's happening and I feel stuck and I just want something new. I want something to change. And so I decided to go for it.
Right.
It can be a shortcut to getting to that next phase of your career. And that's how I looked at it.
I was wondering, because you have such an amazing voice and quite high pitched as well. Just like mine, but in the morning I really can't push out any high notes at all. I was wondering, do you have any sort of technique?
I have, you know, the same thing, like in the morning it's thick, your voice is kind of thick. Mm-hmm. Exercise. Like, get on a treadmill or go for a run. Like, cardiovascular exercise, it's like the quickest way to warm your voice up.
Waanzinnig advies. Ja, ik ga het zeker proberen.
How did you stay relevant after the Idols competition?
It's been an up and down thing. I mean, I don't know if I've always stayed relevant. You know, it's like I was saying, like having the right team of people helping you get to where you want to go is huge. I mean, it's a combination of following your gut and having integrity, but also understanding like the business and being smart about that part of it too. It's, you have to kind of balance the two, I think.
I understand that you've been working with Max Martin.
Mm-hmm.
How was that?
He's amazing. The album that I just put out, The Original High, I worked on it for 2 months in Stockholm. To start all the ideas going. Mm. And then we finished it in LA and Max is like, he's just so like down to earth and he's cool. And I don't know, I think he just has like, he just knows. He just knows what the masses are gonna like, I think.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't know how.
It's a gift.
Yeah.
I have a question about Queen.
Yeah.
Because I'm a bit the rocker of us.
Yeah.
How was it for you to be in Freddie's footsteps, you know?
Yeah, in the beginning, like we started working together right after American Idol, because I sang Bohemian Rhapsody as my audition, and then they came on the finale to do We Are the Champions. And like, it was the first time working together, and there was definitely like, we were like, oh, this feels right, this feels good. And so they stayed in touch with me, and the first time I got on stage with them to do like a medley was at the MTV European Music Awards, and I was so terrified. It wasn't the best performance, you know, it was a little shaky. And I made the mistake of going online and seeing some of the diehard Queen fans rip me apart. And I was like, oh no, I have to do some more work. So the next time, it got a little better and a little better. And I felt so lucky every night getting on stage and getting to sing these amazing songs and being on stage with two rock and roll legends. I mean, it's been wild.
Can you say something in Dutch for me?
I don't know any. Can you help me? Okay, help me.
Ja, mijn Engels is very supergoed. Een beetje boer Engels, maar de Hollanders verstaan me in ieder geval.
Wat?
Wat?
Boer?
Wat de boel?
Niet kent.
Niet kent.
Kent.
Ja.
Eet hij niet.
Eet hij niet?
That's nice.
What does that mean?
Can you explain, please, what it means?
Well, it means what the farmer doesn't know, he won't eat.
Yeah.
No.
Dus wat de boer niet kent, eet hij niet. Dus eigenlijk wou ik geen Engels nummer zingen.
Sorry, I'm a Dutch singer, so...
I feel you, I feel you.
Ja, Adam Lambert, ik kan hem niet teleurstellen. And now I know my heart is a ghost town. There's no one left in this world, I'm gone singing. I don't give it to down, down, down. Of ik tevreden was met hoe ik het heb gezongen? Eigenlijk niet. Ik ben de helft van de tekst was ik kwijt.
It felt intimate, you know, like it felt like you were singing to someone right there. I like that.
Thank you very much. Okay.
And you did it in English.
Yeah, I did it in English.
Ik ga heel snel weer lekker Nederlandse nummers zingen. Ja, dan ben ik gewoon wat sterker in. Tired last night in my dreams, walking the streets, some old ghost town. I tried to believe in God and James Dean, but Hollywood sold out.
Ik vond het redelijk spannend, ja. Maar uiteindelijk ben ik prima tevreden met hoe het is gegaan. En hij leek wel een beetje enthousiast te zijn. Dus dat,
I like that on piano. That's really beautiful.
Yeah.
I like the tone of your voice. It's great. The real key to this song is the emotion of it.
That's for sure.
If you can make their guts wrench and make someone kind of get the goosebumps or whatever, like that's how we get them. Set my heart in the ghost now. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're a great musician. Like you hear really interesting interpretations of this melody. I enjoyed that a lot.
Thank you. Op het moment dat ik daar op die kruk ging zitten, ging ongeveer alles mis.
Oh, sorry.
Ik ben vals, sorry, ik moet even stemmen. Ik was echt spontaan even helemaal vergeten wat ik hier ook weer kwam doen. Daar! Oh fuck, ik zit echt. Sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Maar ja, uiteindelijk ging het wel redelijk. Walked into the flames,
call out your name. But there was no answer. That was cool. That was a vibe. There was a connection with something that he was tapping into. It pulled me in. And now I know my heart is a ghost town. There's no one left in the world. I'm gunslinging. I keep my baby and go down, down, down. I think you got off the words there, but I like that you were like, I'm taking my baby down, down.
Yeah.
I love that.
I didn't know. I forgot. I'm sorry.
But it was a good ad lib. It was cool. Got a voice in my head that keeps singing. Oh, oh, my heart is a ghost town. Today, I think my favorite was Jared. He really paid attention to the words, like they were landing. And when you hit the, ah, I was like, ew! That's good.
You gonna sing a little bit
I'm
first?
I'm very expensive.
Yeah? I can afford it.